is Amrolia, founder director of Chennai Business School, which, as you know, has been functioning here for the last 11 years. Okay. We do a lot of things, essentially getting our students ready for the real world. And this initiative, which we'll talk to you about, is one more step in that process. Okay. This what we call knowledge exchange. One of the things we are very good at is imbibing industry knowledge to students and at the same time making sure that industry gets something back from us. Okay. This particular initiative relates to very simple, easy to use online modules, three modules initially in the HR area, HRMS, travel module and a payroll module, which can be used both by large industries as well as by small industries. One of the reasons we have arrived at this simple plug and play modules is my own experience with CII, where I work with a large number of SMEs. One of the issues we find is that the SMEs are not able to really get the best of people because they cannot pay as well. They cannot afford very big systems like SAP and Oracle, etc., because it's not only costly to buy, but difficult to implement for them with limited resources. So we have developed this module. This module is currently in play in about 5 or 6 companies have already got this module. And the large people like VIT, which I think applies it for nearly 5,000 people, to smaller industries. You know, we keep on reading newspaper reports. For example, IT industry says that only 1 out of 10 or 1 out of 20 is suitable for us in spite of the doing engineering, etc. Now, I think the key lies in the value addition we give in the institute. As against the normal learning by rote, where the student mugs up some question answer without understanding it. And I think one of the things which what we are doing is what others, I think, will follow. Our faculty is essentially industry faculty. They all have been working in industry 15, 20 years. And it's not only retired people. They are regular people who have been in industry who, because they like teaching, have come to us. And they share real life experience of industry, number one. Number two, we focus a lot on making the student think and ask questions rather than mugging up something. You know, we have open answer exams. But if he writes from the book, he gets 0 marks. So we teach the student to ask questions, to understand the concepts for himself so that he becomes more easily employable when he goes to industry. We don't want industry to spend 1 year of their time and money in training somebody to be ready for industry. So these are some of the things. Our interaction with industry, even as a student, is so close and so active. Industry faculty regularly visits. Our students visit industry. Not just they go around with notebooks and come back. No. They go with specific agenda, go along with the faculty to learn what are the practices in the industry. How is it different if you go to an IT industry, young people, large numbers. Other end, you go to a manufacturing industry, far older people, very different aspirations, very different expectations. So we expect them to soak up all that so that they are ready to contribute from day one. I think that is the model which is the future. We, of course, we have modules. Analytics is today very important. And it is applicable across your functions, whether it is finance, HR, marketing. Even if you're an entrepreneur, analytics is important for you. So we have modules on analytics taught by specialists who come from outside. So that is how we make sure that learning really happens. We spend a lot of time in making the student ready. I was here 2 weeks back with the students, wanting them to improve their presentation skills. One of the things, they go to industry, they don't know how to present the ideas, even if they have got thinking. You know, so I think these are some of the things we do, which I think others will have to do. Learning by rote is today on the way out. It really doesn't give any great benefit to students. I think that's what I wanted to say. We take a reasonably good student, need not always be the best. There are some toppers, good student, and make sure that student has the intention and desire to learn, and he has that motivation in that. I think the skill lies in transferring a normal average intelligent student into somebody who can contribute value to industry. I think that requires far more effort then you get the best in. In any case, when they go out, they will remain the best. Okay. I think that is the second, of course, is the issue of resources. The resources of an IIM funded by government, funded by industry, resources of private institutions which are not in that large scale. You know, we take only 40 students and we want to give intensive training to them. We don't take 200, 300 students. So I think there's a different model which we follow. And our interaction with industry is far more intense than many of the IIMs. Okay. The sort of interaction my student has with industry, both ways, is far better, far more intense. But it's a small school, it's a, call it a boutique business school. That's what we want to be. You know, we are in this business not to develop a large learning machine where students come in hundreds and go out by the hundred. No, we want to do something, focus on it and make sure that we do a good job. That's, I think, is the difference between us.